أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه أجمعين. ربي اشرح صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. أما بعد، honorable brothers and sisters, dear believers, respected elders, the best greetings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to all of you. Welcome to another episode of Hope Al-Raja with this important topic called Ways to Keep the Love of Your Wife. Ways. There's so many ways to keep the love of your wife. There's so many high ways to reach your wife's heart. Today we will exhibit some of them. Starting from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Creator, commanded us, actually declared in the Quran. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَنْ خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا وَجَعْلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةَ وَرَحْمَةً. From his signs that he created for you, from you, mates, means wives, so you may dwell in tranquility, and Allah caused among you mawaddah wa rahmah, love and mercy. The Muslim scholars, they look at this verse from the Quran, and they say the major purpose of the marriage, it is not the title, it is not just a show off. The major matter to get married, what you gain, you gain tranquility, sakina. So if you have no marriage, I mean if you have no sakina in your marriage, you just have a marriage certificate. Therefore, the sakina, the tranquility, what you gain as partners in the halal, as partners in this relation, this marriage. Now, mawaddatan wa rahma, love and mercy. Also, they look at this verse and they say, rahma from the husband. Mawaddatan, love from the wife. And of course, this particular ingredients, both of it, if you look at it, it is an ingredients of mercy and love exchange and rotated in between the couples. Now, ways to keep the love of your wife guaranteed, there's up to 99 ways. Today we will exhibit some of them, starting from what's so called. Before we go to that, actually, I would like to mention the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam urged us and advised us by saying, Rifqan bil qawarir. Rifqan bil qawarir, it means be gentle, take care of that fragile vase. Rifqan bil qawarir. My dear brothers and sisters, we look at this one and we think here that the vase, what do you put in the vase? Do you put fist in the vase? No. Do you put rock in the vase? You put flowers. You put something good. You put roses. So that means this heart, the heart of your wife, considered like a vase. What do you put in it? Something good. Now we go to the ways of keeping and preserving the love of your wife. Starting from al-amn, security. Make her feel secure. Make her feel comfortable. Some of the brothers, always they're chewing the gum of Iblis, the gum of the shaitan, threatening his wife, he's going to divorce her. He's going to kick her out of home. Big mistake. Make her feel secure. That's one of the ways to keep the love. Another way, as-salam. As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullah. When you enter your house, your apartment, spread this positive energy called as-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullah. Once you do that, the shaitan is out of your house, out of your apartment, out of your life. A brother said, I went inside my house and then suddenly I was just like arguing with my wife. I was just like firing at her. And then she was so calm, wise, she just turned her back and walked away. He said, I thought, wait a second. When I came home, I did not say, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. He said, Wallahi, I left out for a few seconds and I came and I said, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Even though she doesn't hear me, the evening ended with peace and tranquility. Remember, spread as-salam. Al-karam, another way to keep the love of your wife, being generous. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us, ma akramahunna illa kareem. That means you are indeed a generous person when you are practicing your generosity with your wife. Give her that gift. Simple gift, big gift. Show your generosity. The best way to be generous, first in order and first in the list, the priority goes to your wife. Of course, you want to be generous to mom and dad. That's fine. But we have some brothers, they want to be generous to their friends, generous to their co-workers, generous to every raccoon walks in the street. And then at the end, he remember a little bit of generosity to his wife. Generosity goes a long way. It affects the heart. What else? Big tip to gain the love and to preserve the love of your wife. Pray together. Establish salah together. Go to Umrah. When is the last time you've been in Umrah? Make Hajj together. I mean, it's amazing how it makes an overhaul to the relation and to the love. When you make Hajj and Umrah, it preserves the love. Another way, my dear brothers and sisters, to keep the love. For example, your wife is coming. Give her your seat. Stand up. Give her your seat. Say, here, honey, I warmed up the seat for you. You warm the seat for her, she will warm her heart for you. These small tips, but it works. Try it. Be the judge. It works. It gives you amazing taste for your marriage. It makes you a champion as a husband. Take a look at this one. Ash-shukr bil-ghayb means you are praising your wife at her absence. You know, at the presence of her family, when her mom and dad or her brother's relative is there, if she's not there, speak highly of her. When her children around you, speak good of their mom. That brings love, that preserves the love and to keep the love guaranteed. Al-ibtisama, what does that mean? Al-ibtisama, it means show your pearls, show the smile. Often you smile for everyone. You smile for the people around you, the people in the bus, the streetcar, the people you meet anywhere. But, you know, when it comes to your wife, you think that the face, if it smiles, it's like it becomes, you know, it cracks like a dry bread. You smile for the raccoon in the street, but when it comes to your wife, you think, I'm a man, I want to be harsh. No. وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَضًّا غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ لَنْفَضُّ مِنْ حَوْلِكَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, if you are, this to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you are harsh-hearted, they would break away from you. So that means, be gentle, show that smile. It goes to the heart. Another way. Another way to keep the love and to preserve the love. Sometimes you appreciate your wife. Sometimes you like something about your wife. You like the food. You like the way she's dressed. Whatever. You keep that in your heart. No. Take it out of your heart. Put it in your tongue. Deliver it. Give her that compliment. That compliment, really, flattering is good. Yes, for flattering. No, for arguing. It doesn't mean that if you are soft, means you are not a man. You are a better man, a stronger man when you are soft and gentle with your wife. An-nush. An-nush, often we forget this. You want to advise your wife in the presence of friends, in the presence of family. You start advising her. You start giving her orders and, you know, directions. This good. I mean, the advice, it should be in privacy. As Shafi'i said, تَعَمَّدْنِي بِنُصْحَكَ فِي انْفِرَادِي وَجَنِّبْنِي النَّصِيحَةَ فِي الْجَمَاعَةِ فَإِنَّ النُّصْحَ بَيْنَ النَّاسِ نَوْعٌ مِنَ التَّوْبِيخِ لَا أَرْضَ اسْتِمَاعَةً وَإِنْ لَمْ تَسْمَعْ لِقَوْلِي فَلَا تَجْزَعَنَّ إِنْ لَمْ تُعْطَ طَاعَةً. See, Al-Shafi'i, may Allah be pleased with him, said, intend advising me in privacy. Avoid advising me in the public. Advises in the public, it is a type slandering. I don't listen to, I do not accept. So make sure your advice, it is in privacy. My dear brothers and sisters, another way to keep the love, and this is a major way, another way to preserve her love and the blessing, and to increase the blessing, to have Salat al-Rahm. To encourage Salat al-Rahm means keep a good relation with her family, keep a good relation with her mom and dad, encourage her to visit her mom and dad, encourage her to be in touch with mom and dad, bring gifts to mom and dad, encourage her to call mom and dad, whether in Canada, outside, overseas. Keep that kin relation, keep that Salat al-Rahm. It preserves the love, it brings respect, and brings blessing to the family. Ways to keep the love of your wife. Guaranteed, guarding the tongue. حفظ اللسان, preserve your tongue. Sometimes you could say something to her, you don't mean it, but that breaks her heart. Sometimes you say something and you really don't mean it. What happened? It takes years to wipe out this particular jurh. This particular wound. So therefore, preserve the tongue, especially at the time of anger. If you are angry, make a wudu, sit down, lie down. All this, it is treatment and healing for anger and for you not to lose your tongue and to say something that may take lifetime, may really give her a scar of a lifetime, may never remove that out of her heart. So this way, preserve your tongue at the time of anger. Preserve your tongue. Be careful, because the tongue could be like a snake. It bites you or bites her at a time where you are not paying attention. Honorable brothers and sisters, something called scrub the routine. Ways to keep the love of your wife. Scrub the routine. Surprise her, for example, with a two-night stay at Niagara Falls. Surprise her with something like that. Take the children to the grandparents. Surprise her with 2 days somewhere where she loves. This way you preserve the love and you keep the love guaranteed. Another way to keep the love. And that's something really works. What does that mean? Respect her jealousy and expect her jealousy. I mean, this way, it really worked. Like in a way that when she is jealous, just respect that. Expect that. Respect her shortcoming and expect her shortcoming. Respect the jealousy and expect the jealousy. It preserves the love. It keeps the love. My dear brothers and sisters, as-sabr, another way of keeping the love and preserving the love, as-sabr, being patient with your wife. What does that mean? I'll tell you what does that mean. Sometimes you are in a cliff. If you just go this way, what happened? You fall off the cliff. If you go to the left side, you are landing and you are falling in safety. Sometimes patience needs just a drop of patience, just a sabr. You just need a drop of patience so you'll fall at the safe side. Be patient with her at the time of pregnancy. Be patient with her at the time of her monthly PMS. Be patient with her at the time of a crisis, at the time of hardship. Maybe she did not have a good night's sleep. The children giving her a hard time. Be patient. That just one drop of patience, it goes a long way. Try it. And remember the word, one drop of patience. Al-madi lil-qadi. Ways to keep the love of your wife, to stay away from the past. I'll explain this. A brother phoned me with a terrible fight with him and his wife. What happened? He happened to dig into something his wife did 10 years ago. And every once in a while, they fight about this matter. Something happened 10 years ago. Even at that time, he was not married to her. So, al-madi lil-qadi, the past is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't dig in the past. Don't think that you are the Lord. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in charge of the past. Anytime you dig in the past and you happen to find something called negative or something really sounds bad, it will really affect your life. It will affect the tranquility. It will melt the tranquility, as sakina from your house, from your marriage, from your home. My dear brothers and sisters, others will take whatever they take home. You know, you take for your wife grocery, you take for your wife clothes, for the children, whatever you take. Sometimes we think that we are al-Razzaq. Sometimes you think that you are al-Razzaq, the provider, the sustainer. No, you are not. With me and you, take something home, we are only attal. You know what attal means? It means we are couriers. We carry the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We carry the bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We carry the sustenance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are just couriers. We are not the providers. We are not al-Razzaq. Allah, the creator, al-Razzaq. So don't just, you know, do it in a way like you are doing them a favor. You are bringing them clothes or you are bringing them food. No, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala designated you as a'tal. So this particular designation, it has a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-shaytan na'udhu billah min. Satan is the enemy. Often a couple fighting, arguing, and we say yes to flattering, no to arguing. Often, you know, you argue with your wife. Quit arguing, because arguing, it's from the shaytan. Truly, arguing, إِذَا أَرَادَ اللَّهُ بِقَوْمٍ شَرًّا فَتَحَ عَلَيْهُمُ الْجَدَلُ وَمَنَعَهُمُ الْعَمَلُ. Al-Awza'i said, may Allah be pleased with him, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to cause people evil, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would leave them arguing among themselves and will shut the gate of doing good deeds. So this shaytan, Satan, is the enemy. Don't take your wife as an enemy. Help her against her shaytan. She will help you against your shaitan. So help her against the shaitan. Take the shaitan as an enemy, not your wife as an enemy. Often people forgetting that this is the mother of your children, that this is the person that you want the partnership in love and tranquility, muwaddatan wa rahma, and then suddenly he's taking her as an enemy. My dear brothers and sisters, remember, help your wife against the shaitan, declare the animosity against the shaitan, not against your wife. What else? Ways to keep the love of your wife guaranteed. This is another way, and this is guaranteed. When is the last time, or have you ever took a piece of, you know, chips or a piece of food, a piece of bread, a piece of chicken, whatever? When is the last time you took that and you put it in the mouth of your wife? It doesn't go to the mouth, it goes to the heart. You know, this is actually, it's part of يعني pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and getting rewards, that you take it with your hand and you put it in her mouth. Try it, be the judge, it goes right to the heart, it preserves the love, it keeps the love guaranteed. Al-istima'. Al-istima', this is a major matter. In a husband-wife relationship, often the wife goes and complains to an imam, to a sheikh, to a counselor. She actually doesn't want him to solve her problem. She just wants someone to listen to her. So be that husband, be that man to listen to her, be that receiving element, you know, like the dish, you know, receiving element. Make sure that this ear is like a receiving element. Pay attention, listen to her, pay attention to her need. Even if you don't talk one sentence, just by listening to her, it goes a long way. It preserves the love. It really causes healing and prevent negative energy. My dear brothers and sisters, just remember, رب مستمع خير من متكلم. Often your wife is the engine of the family. What does that mean? You are a doctor. You know, don't look down at your wife because she's home and she's raising the children and I am a doctor, I have PhD, or I am the businessman, I go and I do all type of deals. You know something? You are off balance, you are totally out of even tranquility when you just belittle the partner of your sakina, the partner of your tranquility. If you happen to be a doctor, if you happen to be a businessman, if you happen to be a hard-working person, whatever, don't belittle her just because she's at home raising children. She's the engine of the family. She's the heart of the family, that taking care of your most important asset and the most precious investments for you in your life, and that is your children. So be humble. Being humble and not belittling her, it will raise you in her heart. It will raise you in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We said hadaya al-alsun. Hadaya al-alsun means the gift for the tongues. It's okay to flatter her. It's okay when you feel good to put it in the tongue and deliver it. Show her that you like the way she's dressed, that you like the way she looks, you like, and so delicious her food. Hadaya al-alsun, it means the gift of the tongue. It goes a long way, my dear brothers and sisters, to the heart. Maw'id al-safar, that's another major matter. Some of the brothers, their marriage start deteriorating because of one habit. When he travels, suddenly I'm traveling. Suddenly I'm leaving tomorrow or I'm leaving today. When he come home, when he returned back from his trip, from his journey, he doesn't tell his wife. He just opened the door and that's it. He came. This is actually in Islam. It is not recommended. It is actually a bad practice. Those who just suddenly take off without notice, and then what's even worse, that suddenly come home without notice. Make sure you let her know when you are traveling, when you are coming back. It is ways to keep the love of your wife. Of course, inshallah, another show, we will have ways to keep the love of your husband, guaranteed. But today, we are focused on the wife. Why? Because they say, when the man is happy at home, that means one person is happy. But when the wife is happy at home, that means the whole family is happy and will be happy. So therefore, please allow me today to just concentrate on that headquarter, on that headquarter of happiness, your wife, where Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us the best joy in life, that life is a joy, and the best joy in life is a good wife. My dear brothers and sisters, time is racing so much, and now we have to cut it short, move to another way that keeps the love of your wife guaranteed. What is that? I'll tell you what's that. Privacy and secrecy. You know, the privacy of your home, the secrecy of your home, it is not the property of everyone. It is not a garage sale that you just spread on the table and tell everyone what you have done with your wife. You fought or you did something good. There is holiness for the house. You know, there's a privacy and secrecy for the house. You know, once you spread that, once you expose that to whoever around you, no matter how good they are, actually you will be hurting your marriage. So ways to keep the love of your wife, guaranteed, take care of that privacy, take care of that secrecy. My dear brothers and sisters, we move on the last 1 minute we have, which is, don't expect her to be perfect. Respect her shortcoming. That's one way to keep the love of her wife, the love of your wife guaranteed. Have khuluq al-tatneesh. Khuluq al-tatneesh, sometimes pretend you did not hear that word. Don't just pick on that word and start a fight. Sometimes khuluq al-tatneesh means the manners of just avoiding, you know, pretending that you did not hear something, you know, that might be negative. That way is to keep the love of your wife guaranteed. Another major matter to keep the love of your wife guaranteed, and that's called an-niyya, the intention. My dear brothers and sisters, have a good intention towards each other. It preserves the love. Finally, my dear brothers and sisters, we want to ask you today for something special. Usually we ask you to support this program and to help us stay on air and keep the adhan on air. Today I ask you to pray special prayers for the brother Abdul Karim, Hajj Abdul Karim Al-Ta'amna, which is our brother's dad who passed away yesterday. Pray for him that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unite us with him in the Jannah. Allahumma arham wa iftah alayhi abwab rahmatik fadlak. Ijma'na wa iyyah bil firdaws al a'la. Abdul Karim at-ta'amna, Hajji Abdul Karim at-ta'amna. Jazakum Allah khair, my dear brothers and sisters. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah wa barakatuh.
Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله